That's a good question, but let me pause for a second and say, hypertension or high blood pressure during pregnancy can be labeled as chronic. So if a person already had high blood pressure prior to getting 20 weeks of pregnancy, or we call people to have gestational hypertension as developing high blood pressure after 20 weeks of pregnancy. And then there's the more extreme end called preeclampsia, when a woman has high blood pressure, but she can also have protein in the urine or other things like headaches, nausea, vomiting, blurry vision, shortness of breath, and they can even be severe, what we call eclampsia, which can be seizures. So this is a whole spectrum of what we call hypertensive disorders of pregnancy. And if you have had that during a pregnancy, you are at risk of having it again in future pregnancies, not 100%, but a higher risk. And the risk is even more if you had the preeclampsia at an earlier stage during your pregnancy. So if you've had high blood pressure during pregnancy or preeclampsia, I think that really merits a discussion with a maternal fetal medicine specialist or your obstetrician prior to attempting to get pregnant again. And that really requires a shared medical decision where you kind of discuss what are the risks for you, an individualized risk assessment, and what can we do to prevent it? Should I be eating better, or should I be monitoring my blood pressure more closely, or is it too risky to get pregnant? And if you do decide to move forward with a pregnancy, it really requires careful monitoring of your blood pressure before getting pregnant and throughout pregnancy and in the postpartum stage. And then some doctors even recommend a baby aspirin to kind of help prevent future preeclampsia, and that's usually later on in the pregnancy. So those are kinds of discussions that you want to have to help reduce your risk. So informed decision is the key.